Well, at least she's using a fork and a knife. I mean, right? Hey, everybody. My name is Old School Nerd. Welcome. Now, this is an anthem song. This is an anthem song that goes all the way back to when I was, oh, I don't know, 3 years old, 2 years old. I'm an old dude. Okay, so Gloria Gaynor made a song called I Will Survive. And it was a song about a woman who looked back on a past relationship that was toxic and troublesome. She shrugged it off. It was an anthem to a lot of people that said, you know what? My ex does not define me. Because of my ex, I am a better person. And I will carry on. Well, that's kind of what this is. And it's Violet Orlandi's I Will Survive. And it's featuring the Melodica Brothers. And I think she's also on the Melodica Brothers channel doing a Britney Spears song. Okay. All right, so we're going to do this one. By the way, I do love the original by Miss Gloria, and she owns this thing. However, a lot of people can remember back in the 90s when a little band called Cake did a remake of this, and their remake of it was spectacular. And it's about 50-50 as to which one was better. The original is still just, it's right here. But that one that Kate did makes you want to dance. What if I told you there was one done and I've never heard a recording of it. I've never seen a video of it. There's a certain band from Dallas, Texas. Not Pantera, shut up. There's a band from Dallas, Texas that used to play this song on all of their live sets. This and Going the Distance by Cake. And it was so heavy and so upbeat and fast, the crowd would go nuts. So Violet has not only the classic to hold up to, she's got the remake from Cake, and the fact that I've seen a band do this one live so much so, people come running from down the street and try to jam into trees just to see them perform it. By the way, October, trees, electric callboy. All right, everybody, my name is Old School Nerd, and this is Violet Orlandi. Doing some epic stuff. Let's get into it.
At first I was afraid, I was petrified. Kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. But then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong. And I grew...
Okay, so she's got pork. That's pork. If it's not pork, that's a very unhealthy bunch of beef covered in some kind of, looks like ketchup or ancho sauce. Raw on a plate. Hopefully it's movie magic and she didn't really eat this, because that would be really bad. So
strong, and I learned how to get along. And so you're back from outer space. I just walked in to find you here with that sad look upon your face. I should have changed that stupid lock. I should have made you your keys. If I'd known for just 1 second, you'd be back to bother me. Gone. Walk out the door, just turn around now, cause you're not welcome anymore. Weren't you the one who was trying to break me with goodbye? Did you think I'd crumble? Did you think I'd lay down and die? Oh no, 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 I will survive.
Okay, so there's some mixing of different meats here. So I don't know if they left the pork or... I don't know how they pulled this off and her not get really, really sick. It could be extremely fresh pork and beef. I don't know. But that's way over the top. That's a lot. Also, what the hell kind of ring crap is going on? Rapid reversal of camera, changing up of the cut. Of course, she stops. She smiles at the camera in the most innocent look she could possibly give. And you know, she's full of shit. There's nothing innocent about this. Also, the song is well done. very raw. The Melodica brothers are putting in that classic guitar riff into it. There's no disco vibe to it. There's no none of that club crap. And it's very personal because you can hear the texture in her voice. It's very, very connected. Some versions of the song, it seems like someone's talking to someone in their past. You could almost feel like she's talking directly to you across the dining room table under candlelight. Very personal. It's intense.
To mend the pieces of my broken heart, and I spent oh so many nights just feeling sorry for myself. I used to cry, but now I hold my head up high, and you sing me somebody new.
I like the singular track in the back. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna put my arranger, composition, producer hat on. Okay, there in the musical composition, the guitar is stereoed, and then there's a little portion in the back, and I want you to listen to it, that breaks it down to an old singular mono track in the back, very lightly in the gain, and it adds a depth to it, but also gives a kind of a throwback, that 70s analog feel. Listen.
And I spent oh so many nights just feeling sorry for myself. I used to cry, but now I hold my head up high, and you sing me.
That little, the snare is just, the snare sounds like someone's playing it non-stereo. And whenever they recorded it, it was recorded like someone's playing a snare across the room from the microphone. That's probably all done electronically, you know, put it in the tag, pull the gain out, you know, but it's really good. It gives a textural difference. It gives you different textures. Also, I'm having trouble watching this video, and it has nothing to do with Violet. It's just the fact that when I was in the Army, in the military, we went to a local place to eat food, and it was in Belize. We were doing an exercise for a disaster recovery refugee exercise. So we went down to Belize to do this work, and we went to a local place, and we had pork. And it was not cooked all the way. And I was violently sick for a week. And I never forgot that. Which is one of the reasons why my kids go, Dad, why are these pork chops like really, really well done? It's because I can't help myself, guys. It's going to be that way forever. Sorry. And to see her eat this, and I'm assuming with the pork that was laid out on the plate to start the video, it's not what she's eating now. But in my head, it is... If you've ever been sick from eating a food, like violently ill from eating a food, and then you see that food being consumed in a way that brings you back to what possibly happened to you, even though it has nothing to do with what happened to you, it is a primal response. Whew, this is a lot.
Oh,
I am paying attention, but I'm also messaging Violet right now directly. Oh my God, tell me you really didn't eat raw pork. And I just want to see if she replies. Because sometimes she does reply to things. And I want to know, but in my brain, in some ways, I don't want to know. I'm sorry. This is one of those times where you feel for someone. And I met this person in real life. She's a lovely person, right? A little quiet for me, but then I'm a loud asshole, so it's okay. But man, please tell me it's movie magic and she didn't eat raw pork. And it, you know, and hey, for all I know, in Brazil, raw pork may be a dish that's served there, and it's okay if it's prepared properly and whatnot. But dude, like for real, like this is really disturbing me. I'm like, this is hard. Oh, and the song is great. So Old School Nerd did a reaction to Violet Orlandi, and all he could talk about was raw pork. Was the song good? I don't know. What was the song? I think it was something from the 70s. No. It's one of the greatest breakup songs ever written. Greatest. The greatest. You see that smile? No, you see that? Right there. Do you see it? No, not the beautiful eyes and wonderful smell. The plate of raw pork. Really? Oh, God. Man. Still a better love story than Twilight, though. It's true. Cheers. Oh my God. Wow. All right, everybody. As we let her Patreons roll, I just want to say thank you to everyone who, wow. I mean, okay. See this guy right here? Number one, he's a dick. Okay. I am proud to be a Patreon of hers, and if nothing else, to have her stomach pumped after eating raw pork. Oh my God. Like seriously. I mean, I'm just checking. She won't answer me. She's not going to answer me. She's going to be like, yeah, I could answer Old School Nerd's raw pork comment, but then why ruin the moment? Let him just think it is. All right. This is, my name is Old School Nerd, and this is Violet Orlandi. I'm reacting to her amazing song, and she's giving me food poisoning flashbacks. Love you guys. Hey, if you're not her Patreon, if you're not following her on YouTube, what the hell's wrong with you? Don't forget, hopefully her new full album will be coming out. I know she's still working on it all the time. I love her original stuff. She's one of the best cover people in the world. I mean, come on. She just did Gloria Gaynor. Yeah, it's awesome. And for the next Holocene run, the next We Miss You, Violet. Love you. Wish we could see you soon. Hey, and who knows? Violet may do a world tour. You don't know. Things happen all the time. The world's funny like that. Speaking of funny, I'm out of here. We'll talk to you guys later. Raw pork. Oh my God. There's no way she ate raw pork. I'm just... but yeah, it's still a better love story than Twilight.